Hi, wee Bob here. It's typical every season weather here in Scotland, from rain to snow to sunshine, and I'm sitting in my wee cosy studio with my hot cup of Scottish blend tea. When we left Dug the last video, he was having a great time at the beach, and we will get on to more of that in his story a wee bit later in this video. I was asked a question in the comments about the default paper and whether it was textured or not in the latest version of Sketchbook Pro, and the default paper is just plain. Hit the edit menu and then go to the preferences. We can then go to the canvas tab and we can see the width, the height and resolution. My default is shown here. You can specify in millimeters or inches from the drop down menus to the right if that is something you want to do. The paper options in Sketchbook Pro are quite basic compared to other drawing packages that I use. We click OK to exit and we will have our default canvas with the default layout. The pinned brush set is over on the left. We can choose any of our brush sets and pin them in this brush palette as it is known. If we click on the melted Space Invader icon, aka brush library, we can see all the brush sets we have available to us. You can download brush sets as detailed in the description of this video. To add a brush set, we go to the dotted circle in the top right hand side of the Sketchbook menu. We want to choose Import Brush Set, and Sketchbook Pro should default open to an Explorer page where your brush sets are stored. We click it and click open. In this case, we have chosen the Textured Watercolors brush set. We can then pin this brush set by using the dotted circle and clicking the Pin Set to Palette button. To really understand what you have in Sketchbook Pro in terms of brushes, we want to do what I would call a crib sheet. And the reason I say this is that as I was doing this week's drawing of Dug the Pug that you've seen at the start of this video, I really struggled with what brushes to use and what would give me the particular effect that I was looking for. So walking through each of the brushes in the set without making any changes to their settings, we can draw a line with the light pen pressure through to heavier pressure to see what effect it gives. As we do this exercise, I will give you a feel for pens you like and ones you're not so keen on. After drawing the lines, I would suggest you draw blades of grass to see again what effect Sketchbook Pro gives for each of the brushes with their default settings. In this set, we do not just have brushes, but we also have blenders, and as part of your crib sheet, you want to lay down some lines and do some blending just to get a feel for the blending brushes and the effect that they can create, because they're good for clouds, they're good for waves, etc. Before we go into the real superpower of Sketchbook Pro in terms of brushes, I had to draw Brie because I hadn't done so this week, and I used a previous drawing but it was a wee bit too racy, so I decided to make it a wee bit more PG, and I'm going to show you the first few pages of Dug the Pug, and then we're going to move on to more of the story a wee bit later on and talk about advanced brushes. So the lighthouse story that my mum told me starts out with a little boy living in the lighthouse as the storm clouds approach, as we discussed in the last video, with his parents. His parents realise that they've not got much food, they've just got some bread and water left, and they need to head to the mainland to get food. They're going to leave the boy behind because he's old enough to be trusted, and he says goodbye to his mum and dad and they wave farewell as they set sail. The story of Dug is slightly different, but it's based on this original story that I was told when my mum gave me a piece of bread to nibble along as she told the story of the wee boy in the lighthouse. But Dug lives with Brie, they're out having a great time at the beach, and they're then settling down for their dinner, getting their jammies on, thinking about Sean the shark, and we'll get back to these stories either in this video or in the next video, and we'll progress with Dug's story. But at the moment he's getting ready for his wee cosy bed and getting a wee bedtime story about Dipsy Dory. But for the moment I want to discuss some of the greatest powers that Sketchbook gives us, from layers to the advanced brushes and the advanced brush settings that we have available to us. So we're going to look at this little flower drawing by Beautiful Dawn Designs on .net, I believe it is, and that's what I used to try and get a real watercolour look. But like I mentioned, Brie was a wee bit too adult for a children's book, and I wanted to use something I'd already drawn because I didn't have a lot of time to create a new Brie. And in this case I just used a manga brush and then a multiply layer, so if you look for the multiply layer over on the right, and then some blending, so blending some of the other aspects of the design away, reshaping her form, getting rid of this kind of weird scarf that's going round her body, and just filling it in as a t-shirt, as though she's wearing a t-shirt. This was me originally designing Brie back a few weeks ago, as you can see. And then I'm using a blender brush to try and blend some of those bigger details, make them look a bit more subtle. And this is where blending brushes really come into their own, because they can give you that round shape of the shoulder or the arm. They can also help you sculpt the back into the proper shape. And they're really powerful, you just need to make sure you're in the correct layer. But to make this t-shirt better, I started playing around with layer types, colour, burn, lighten, multiply, and eventually I got to screen, and it just seemed to work, this kind of white and blue t-shirt. And I was really happy with it, to be honest. It gave the correct look, but Brie was looking a bit sad, so I needed to change her expression. And this will show you how quickly you can change someone's expression by little minor details. And this is why you've got to be careful when you're drawing, to make sure that you are getting the expression correct in what you're trying to portray. And little tiny items can actually make quite a big difference. So I was just blending out that kind of sadder face, giving her a bit more of a happy face. I didn't want to go too far, like I said before. And we're carrying on with looking at now the advanced brushes. So in the advanced brushes, the brushes all have this little setting at the top called brush properties, and it gives you access to all aspects of the brush. Now to begin with, I just used the default, and to see if I could add a wee bit to the existing watercolour painting and make it look the same, or at least as though it was part of the drawing to begin with. And I think it was achieved quite well through Sketchbook, using just the default brushes. But then we've got all these little sliders that we can play with. We've got the size with heavy pressure and light pressure, so that's to do with how heavy you lean on the pen. And we've got the other things like opacity, which is to do with dark and light, how much, how dark or how opaque the brush will be. Now, even with watercolours, it's quite difficult sometimes to get that setting to do what you want it to do, even if you're on a pure black setting. And I'll show you another setting that you can look at if that's a problem that you're having. But one thing that you can do with these brushes, and it's almost the opposite of the watercolour method, where you take the stroke and you go out from the page as though you're going towards the end of the leaf. And what I would suggest to you is that you try using Sketchbook slightly differently, and you come back towards the stem of the leaf. This is another setting called spacing, which lets you just change the kind of properties of the brush. The best thing here is to experiment and try to get the look of the brush that you want. But I wanted to get on and try some stuff, so we made a new multiply layer. If I want that texture of the paper to come through, I really want to be in a multiply layer. And what I've done is I've created a copy of my brush, and this one we're going to rename in the brush properties fine tip testing. We now then can look at testing a brush without really affecting the original brush that we had as part of our set. And we're going to work through some of these different sliders and just discuss some of the things that you can make. So one of the big things is the texture. And I'm going to suggest that you go get a really opaque brush and put down a splodge of paint on your paper, and then go to what's called capture. Now you can increase the size of your brush and then capture, so you get a black, pure black texture panel, as you can see on the left hand side there. This then gives you access to these other three sliders called scale, brightness and contrast. I would recommend that you really go in there with the different textures and you try playing around with these sliders, just try out the brushes to see what you can get. And as you can see, I was trying to get a kind of uniform type brush, but it was big at the beginning and small at the end to give this leaf shape, which worked quite well. But go into those textures, see what you can find, try the different ones just to see how it affects the leaf shape that you're trying to get. Now up the top, one of the things that you always kind of see is this size with heavy pressure, size with light pressure, and I would recommend that you try changing them around, because it can give you a really cool effect, like this effect of almost a fairy, what do you call it, dandelion type effect for a flower. And that's really what you're wanting to do with your brushes. You want to just get in there, get experimenting and see what you can find out. Tell me in the comments what type of picture book or story would you tell. If you've liked this video, please leave a like. Now, is this the best watercolour software. I say no, Rebel 5 has these crazy features that you can see demonstrated just now. If you haven't seen my video on that, go check it out, it's in the top right hand corner. Cheers for watching, and Wee Bob is out.